You seem to understand the Indian point of view, Benteen.
Watch your head! Grab the stick! Grab it, Charlie, and try to steer! Try to steer it! Ah, boy! We're coming to a left! Turn, push it to the left!
Are well within their rights, sir. The treaty gives them the authority when they're on their territory.
Welcome to the fort. Troops ready for inspection, sir.
Thank you, Major. Morning, Surgeon. Got an epidemic here, have you?
Malingerers, every one of them.
Do you mind if I have a word with your patients if they're not too sick?
They're as healthy as mules.
Thank you, Surgeon. All right, Cook. Many of the men skip breakfast?
None, sir.
What do they have, a good meal?
Yes, sir. Liver onions.
Liver and onions.
Flapjacks.
Flapjacks.
Steak.
Steak.
Fried potatoes.
Fried potatoes.
Biscuits.
Biscuits.
Pie and coffee.
Pie and coffee, all right. Thank you, Cook. Surgeon, this epidemic, do you think it's got something to do with my orders to move out against the Cheyenne?
General, this epidemic gonna last just as long as your orders stand.
Major, I want all the men out here in 10 minutes with rifles and full packs.
Yes, sir.
That goes for officers too, Major Reno.
Yes, sir.
You heard what the man said? On the parade ground, in full field gear, in 10 minutes. Get the ladder!
Double time! Halt! out of range. Sergeant Gaskins?
Sir.
Well, now, all right. Bring up the cannon.
Yes, sir.
Fire.
Dispatch to General Sheridan. Despite overwhelming odds, a great victory was won here today. Factors contributing to our success were one, the Indians were asleep. Two, the women and children offered little resistance. Three, the Indians are bewildered by our change of policy.
Come on. yellow as butter. Did you ever see the light, Captain?
You're under arrest, Mulligan.
Mr. Mulligan's the name now, sir, and happy to see you this fine morning.
Come off it, Patty. I'm taking you back for desertion.
Desertion?
If it's men you need, Captain,
I'll buy you one in my place. 5. 50. I'll buy you a whole regiment. And every man in it will be named Paddy Mulligan.
Where are the others, Mulligan?
The trouble started no sooner we were out the gate. Some wanted to go north, some wanted to go south. I should have known I couldn't get them to stick to hard work. For that matter, neither could I. I just wanted to take off my army boots and cool my feet in the clear waters of that stream. And that's how I found the gold. Lovely, isn't it? There's enough here for both of us, Captain. Think of all the good things a decent man like you could do with it. Oh, well. Back it goes. Sooner or later, some other lucky man will find it. Well, now I guess I better put on my boots, huh? I'll do you no harm, Captain. You can have your gun back. Just let me go. All I ask is your word. Desertion. I suppose that's serious business.
Sergeant, your appeal has been processed and denied. Now you have got to present me with new facts.
Facts. That's right. Facts.
That's what the men all admire about you, General. You always know all the facts.
You're talking off the point.
I'm talking for my life, General.
You haven't said a single word I could give to a court in new evidence. You haven't said anything to make me think that you wouldn't desert all over again.
Rules. Regulations. Court-martials. I'm talking about the juice in a man's veins. I'm talking about all the good times you never had.
Off the point, you say.
Well, drinking. Girls. Smoking cigars. Chasing rainbows. That's the point. You've got no feelings, General. There's just an empty place inside. A hole stuffed with rubbish. The flag. The regiment. Duty.
You listen to me, Mulligan. You didn't think twice about the soldiers you left behind to do your job. Or maybe they'd get killed doing it. All you ever wanted was to strike it rich.
Well, it wasn't to get rich. I didn't desert for the gold. It was for all those other reasons. That's what I've been trying to tell you. Those are the facts!
Sergeant, maybe you wanted too much out of life. Maybe life doesn't have that much to offer. Guard.
Ready? Aim. hostiles?
Nope. They're here, all right. I can feel it.
Here they're talking about appointing General Custer as governor of the Dakota Territory.
Can't read, son, never could. My kind of business, a man don't need to read. I don't like anything but gold to touch the skin. Even here in my mouth, son. See that? You know why, son? You know why? I like the taste of gold.
Thank you. You say there's an article in there about General Custer becoming governor? He gets my votes. He's the one that opened up the territories. The gold territory. Yes, he sure did.
Uncouple the car. We can roll down. I'll cover you.
There is no Indian problem. There is only a white problem. You ask why we nurse hostile tribes one day and kill them the next.
Why we sign treaties with one hand and shoot them down with the other.
The answer in a single word is corruption.
The American people have the right to know who's responsible.
The answer is,
look to those who are reaping the profits from this dual policy.
There is no point in investigating the military. I defy you to find a single rich officer in the entire United States Army. There's no soldier with his safe stuffed with gold bonds and railroad shares. Guilty parties. You are going to have to look right here in Washington.
And you are going to have to look in high places.
I know the men who are responsible. And I'm going to give you their names.
You must lead your peoples back to the reservations. You must go back.
Yellow hair.
Three armies on the way.
They'll wipe you out.
They'll be here tomorrow.
Today is a good day for fighting.
Our fighting is over. It's over, I tell you. Trains, steel, guns that kill by thousands, no horses.
It's over.
Steel, just steel, no men. All this, it's finished. This is all over.
For the last time, then.
The charge, Sergeant. We're going after Custer.
But Lieutenant, his orders were to wait.
I'm in command.
Help!
And Benteen. I want them men up here quick.
Yes, sir.
You four at the end of the column, follow me.
Sergeant, we're gonna have to stand here. Form a perimeter. All right,
give the order. Dismount.
Until I give the order.
He's saving you for the last.
I know.
Don't let him take you, General.
You seem to understand the Indian point of view, Benteen.
Watch your head! Grab the stick. Grab it, Charlie, and try to steer. Try to steer it. Grab it, boy. We're coming to a left. Turn, push it to the left. Fire! All right, hold it steady now.
Are well within their rights, sir. The treaty gives them the authority when they're on their territory.
Yes! Hunt!
Fire! What against the Cheyenne?
General, this epidemic is going to last just as long as your orders stand.
Major, I want all the men out here in 10 minutes with rifles and full packs.
Yes, sir.
That goes for officers too, Major Reno.
Yes, sir.
You heard what the man said? On the parade ground, in full field gear, in 10 minutes. Get the ladder!
Double time!
Double time! Hold!
Troop, halt!
Right shoulder. Arms!
All right. Knock one down.
Welcome to the fort. Troops ready for inspection, sir.
Thank you, Major. Morning, Sergeant. Got an epidemic here, have you?
Malingerers, every one of them.
Do you mind if I have a word with your patients if they're not too sick?
They're as healthy as mules.
Thank you, Sergeant. All right, Cook. Many of the men skip breakfast?
None, sir.
What do they have, a good meal?
Yes, sir. Liver and onions.
Liver and onions.
Flapjacks.
Flapjacks.
Steak.
Steak.
Fried potatoes.
Fried potatoes.
Biscuits.
Biscuits.
Pie and coffee.
Pie and coffee. All right, thank you, Cook. Surgeon, this epidemic, do you think it's got something to do with my orders to move?